In this video, we're gonna take a look at what a WordPress theme is and what different kinds of WordPress themes are available. I'm Tim from realwebsitehints.com, and it's my focus to help you find the best and easiest way to build a website. This is video 3 in my series on how to get started building a website with WordPress. If you missed the other videos in this series, be sure to click on the eye icon at the top of the screen to start the series from the beginning. Some of the themes that I'm talking about in this video, I have an affiliate relationship with. So if you like this content and you want to support it, check out the links below. It'll cost you nothing extra, and it provides me with a commission that helps me to test and review the products so I can help you find the best and easiest ways of building websites. Deciding on which WordPress theme you're going to use for your website is probably the most important decision that you will make. It's the theme that really creates your website and your web pages in WordPress. You can write a page using WordPress software, but that page won't have a look, a design, or even be visible until you have a WordPress theme to create the web page that your viewers will see. The theme that you choose can really be the difference between easily building a website and getting very frustrated in building your website. I have 3 different categories that I put WordPress themes into. There are static themes, theme frameworks, and page builder themes. Let's take a look at each of these different types of themes. Static themes are the first type of themes that were created for WordPress. Static themes are also the most common types of WordPress themes that you'll find. In fact, most WordPress installs come with a few static themes installed by default. These are the 20-something themes, like the 2017 theme or the 2016 theme. I call these static themes because the page layout and most, if not all, of the design of your web pages are decided by the creator of the theme. You may get a few options on colors or fonts, but the basic layout and design of your pages are all decided by the theme creator. If you want to make changes to the look or the layout of the theme, you'll need to modify the code of the theme. One of the benefits to static themes is that if they're very basic themes, it's easy to change the look of your website by just changing the theme. The first themes that I started out with were static themes. I found them to be extremely frustrating. I would find a theme that I liked and then enter my content and create my pages, only to discover that either my content or the types of images I used didn't look good with that theme. The only way to make these changes was to modify the code of the website. Since I'm not very good at code, I found this to be very time-consuming and extremely frustrating. So the next type of themes are theme frameworks. These themes are designed to be starting points for creating your own theme or your own website design. Frameworks are designed to be modified by adding a child theme to the main framework theme. So what's a child theme? A child theme is additional code that you add on top of the base theme to modify the look or the layout of the theme design. Often you will find framework themes that come with their own child themes, or that you can purchase different child themes for that framework separately. Two of the most popular frameworks are the Genesis theme and Thesis themes. These are very high quality products. However, to really modify and get the page layouts and the look and feel that you want, you still need to know how to code. Now, the last type of themes are page builder themes. Page builder themes are designed to allow you to create your own pages and layouts easily without you having to know how to code. These are definitely my favorite types of themes, and I think they're the best types of themes for people new to building websites with to get started. Most of the latest page builder themes have what are called front-end page builders. This means that you can see the design you're working on as you're working on it. The older type of page builders had a wireframe style layout designer, which are still great, but it's not quite as intuitive to use as the front-end page builders. Two of my favorite page builder themes are the Divi theme and the Beaver Builder theme. I have reviews of both of these themes that you can check out. You can actually add page builder functionality to just about any theme, and there are several page builder only plugins available for WordPress. Divi and Beaver Builder both offer standalone plugins for use with other themes. I don't recommend this, however, because it just adds additional complications to your website setup. I like to keep things simple. I find that when you keep things simple, you tend to have fewer problems. It's rare, but I have seen cases where a theme and a plugin become incompatible with each other. And so for that reason, I recommend either using a theme with a built-in page builder like the Divi theme, or a theme like Beaver Builder, which offers a theme and page builder plugin in one package, and that both the theme and the plugin are made by the same company and are designed to be used together. Another issue with page builder plugins and separate themes is that unless the theme is designed to be used with a page builder, you're probably gonna have a difficult time getting the design to look the way that you want it to. most page builder plugins will be confined to the content area that the theme offers rather than allowing you to fully design the look of your pages. So those are the basic different types of WordPress themes that are available. And what I've learned about building WordPress websites over the last few years is that if you want to have a good experience and you want building your websites to be easy, it's really about choosing the right theme. If you don't know how to code and you want flexibility in the design of your website, you're going to want to use a page builder theme. It's the best way to easily build your web pages. I'd recommend for anyone starting out building a WordPress website to go with a page builder theme. Themes like Divi and Beaver Builder are easy to use and give you flexibility to design your site the way that you want. So what's next? Well, get started building your website. You now know the fundamentals of what you need to build a WordPress website. It's time to get started doing it. I've got a few different tutorials that'll walk you through the entire process step by step. And I'll link to my top tutorial series in the description below and at the end of this video. This tutorial will introduce you to my favorite tools and services for building WordPress websites with, and it will show you exactly how to do it. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. And if you'd like to see more reviews, guides, and tutorials, please be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Otherwise, go ahead and get started building your website. Check out my free website building tutorial series, and let's get started. We'll be right back.